Hi DIYers, Sterling with Alarm Grid here. Today we're going to show you how to program a Honeywell 5814 wireless ultra small door and window transmitter. This 5814 consists of a contact and a magnet. Just like any surface mount device, it protects for openings. So doors, windows, cabinets, things like that. When the sensor and the magnet are aligned, the zone is happy. When the magnet or the sensor move away from each other with the door or the window opening, it sets off the alarm. On the side of the unit, you have a slight indication of a triangle, and that shows you which side the magnet works on. Putting the magnet on this side, or this side will give unexpected results and, you know, faults when you're not expecting them. So we always recommend that you follow the indication and put the magnet on the side that has the little mark. To power up the unit, we have a battery. It's a CR2430 3-volt coin cell lithium battery, and we have our battery holster. We have our serial number here, and obviously the battery would cover that, but we also have our serial number here, so it's okay. So to install the battery, we always do positive side up, and we just snap it into place, and now the panel or the sensor has power. There is a small tamper switch, push button switch in the corner there. And on the back cover, there's a little post that holds down the tamper and makes sure that when you're closing it up, your post is in line with your tamper button so that you don't get unexpected tamper faults. On the back of here, there's no way to use screw terminals, so they give you a nice little piece of double-sided tape. You get a smaller portion for the magnet and a bigger portion for the device. You would stick it on the back and affix it to your door or your window. So now that we know how the 5814 is used, you can see obviously the footprint of this device is much smaller than any other surface mount sensor that we've shown you. And the advantage of this unit is for decor purposes. This gives you a much smaller footprint, blends in real nice on a door or a window. So in fancier homes or on doors and windows with fancier decor, this is a great option. To enroll the device, just like with any Honeywell wireless sensor, we go Security, More, Tools, and type in our installer code, 4112. And then we go to Program, and finally Zones. On the Zone screen, we highlight and hit the down arrow until we get to our next available new zone. Any zone showing new has not yet been set up, and we don't have anything programmed to that zone, so we know we can use it. You highlight it and click Edit, and now you're into the zone screen. The first thing you always want to do when you're learning in your sensor is to set the serial number. And you can do that one of two ways with this device. One way is to simply key in the serial number. So if we look on the side here, 062-0288, done. And if we very quickly exit out, we keyed it in,
door.
We can see it works. It faults and it says door. So that certainly is one way to do it. The other way, if we clear that serial number out, to avoid any user input errors, or another reason that you would want to do the auto enrollment is to verify that the sensor actually works. Let's say we had dropped this device and the read switch was broken. Highlighting that serial number, it would have keyed in no problem, but then if we tried to use the device, it wouldn't work, and we'd be left to wonder what's going on. So to avoid the confusion and to verify it works before we even test it, if we auto-enroll it by activating it 3 times, then we know the sensor works and we know the serial number got entered in properly. So to activate, you simply have the magnet to the side that it needs to be on, and you pull it apart to simulate the door or the window opening. Put it back, and you get your beep, and that's your first activation. Do that again. You get your double beep, and you get your serial number with your loop number. This device will always get learned in with loop number 1. That's the only loop that this device should ever be programmed with. You do it a third and final time, and we've locked in our settings, and it takes us back to the main door page. Okay, this we're going to put on our patio door. because we have a really nice patio door and we didn't like the bigger boxier sensors that we used earlier in the rest of the house, so that's why we got the 5814 in this case. The patio door is a door that sometimes we exit when we're armed, or more likely some of our family members forget that the system is armed and they use the door. So our options for response type for door is perimeter, entry exit one, or some of these other options. If we had it set to perimeter and we armed it and we forgot it was armed and we opened the patio door to go out to the deck, we would get an instant alarm. We probably would learn very quickly never to do that again. But because we've forgotten a few times, we're gonna make it entry exit one. Now, if the door is opened, the panel beeps at us to disarm the system and we can remember, okay, the system's armed, I have to go disarm and then I can exit without setting off the alarm. That entry exit one allows us to have that reminder. Also, if we ever wanted to enter the property through the patio door, we could, and we would have time then to get to the keypad and turn off the system. So again, entry exit one gives you delays to come and go. Perimeter is instant alarm in the arming mode. So we could leave it door only, but because we have multiple doors in our home, we would like to know which door is which.
Panic. Patio.
And by hitting the P, we get taken to the first P word in the library. We hit the down arrow twice to get to the word patio, and we click done. So now we have patio door with a delay. Alarm report is yes. That means our system is monitored, and this sensor activation will send a report to the central station so that the operators can respond. Chime we set to standard. That means when this device is activated in the disarm state, which is a fault, the panel will respond and speak the words patio door, and it will show a fault and we know that the door is open. Supervision is supervised. That means that the panel will look and check for this device every 12 hours. If the device is not seen by the panel, whether it's out of range or has interference or somehow has been destroyed, or perhaps if we keyed in the serial number improperly, we would get a supervision error. That's the panel letting us know there's a problem with this sensor. So it's important to have any intrusion device set to supervision so that you know in advance if you ever have a problem with a particular zone or sensor. So we have our zone 25 all keyed in, ready to go, and we save our parameter. If we exit to the home screen, we can test to make sure we programmed our 5814 properly. So again, with the magnet on the side of the device with the little hash mark, we open our door, which pulls the magnet away. You can see that the panel spoke the word patio door. It also gives us this nice visual indication of an open door with the fault of the specific zone number and the name of the specific zone that is open. So if we ever went to go arm the system and we saw this screen, we would know, okay, we don't have to guess at what's open. We know it's the patio door. We must have left that open from when we were out on the deck. We simply close the door, and now we have our options to arm. As soon as we open the door again,
patio door.
It does the fault. It gives you the patio door indication that it's open again, and that is how we know the sensor is working and programmed properly to our Lynx Touch L5200. So we hope you've enjoyed that 5814 programming video. And we invite you to subscribe to our channel. And if you ever have any questions on your Honeywell wireless sensors or system, please let us know by emailing us support@alarmgrid.com.